Okay guys, so in this video, I will tell you the three signs which will help you identify whether you are going bold or not. And this is coming from a guy who is experienced in boldness, has, I would say, gone through the other side. I started bolding when I was about 18 years old. I'm now 25, so that's 7 years of bolding. So I'm talking from my own personal experience, 7 years of it. And I want to sort of pass that knowledge to you to help you decide whether or not you're going bold so you can start to take action. So there's normally two different ways that guys go bold, and either that's from the front or from the back, from the crown area. So from the front, often you'll get your sort of traditional widow's peak where the corners of the hairline move back and he's sort of left with the peak at the front, or the whole hairline gradually moves back as well. So there's both, but either way, the receding starts from the front and moves back. The second way is from the crown, which is what I experience, and I find that from the crown, normally you start with a small balding spot, the balding spot starts to get wider, and I find there tends to be more of a diffused thinning. And by diffused thinning, I mean the overall area on the top of your head starts to get thinner when you start to go bold from the crown. So that's speaking from my own personal experience, from having a look into other people's experience as well of going bold, that if you go from your crown, you get more of a diffuse thinning, whereas if you start to recede from the front, the hairline just moves back and you don't get as much diffuse thinning. So as you guys will know, or potentially not know, hair loss is 90% genetic, if not more. So there's not much you can do to control it. So what I always encourage is focus on what you can control. So the first sign that I'll tell you about is the fine, thin, short hairs that you may get in areas of balding. So either from the front, you may start to get what looks like baby hairs, a very fine, wispy, thin hairs. They don't grow as long. I get that on my crown as well, where the follicle, because of the male pattern balding process, the follicle begins to close up. And as that follicle begins to close up, the hair gets thinner and thinner and weaker and weaker. So what you're left with in areas of balding is quite fine, thin hair. So that's the first sign. So where you previously had thick hair, maybe it's on the corners or at the front or on the crown, where you previously had thick hair, strong hair, and that hair is starting to become finer, weaker, then that is the first sign of balding. Also in those areas of finer, thinner hair, you may notice that the light begins to shine through. So if someone's ever taken a video of you, this is how a lot of guys realize they're starting to go bold, is because someone's taken a photo or a video of them and they can notice the light shine through right directly onto the scalp. That is also a sign. That's because, as I said, the hairs there are thinner and finer. So as the light shines through, especially if it's a strong light, potentially the sun, which is directly overhead, it shines right down through onto the scalp. This is what I notice. I'm going to put some photos up for you so you can see. So that just links in with the finer baby hairs, and that is the first sign that you're going bold. The second sign to look out for is you notice a lot of hairs coming off your head. Maybe as you wake up in the morning, there's loads of hairs on your pillow, in the shower, even as you just sort of run your hair through your hands, maybe you get loads of hairs in your fingers and in your hands as well. So you guys have probably heard, right, that yeah, it's normal for 100 hairs to fall out every single day. But when there looks like a significant amount of hair coming out and it's constantly coming out, then that could potentially be a sign of balding. So I thought that for a long time. I thought, you know, yeah, it's just normal, it's fine. People always tell me 100 hairs come out every single day. But I think that was the first sign of me going bold. That started around 18 years old, something like that. Whilst the hair loss at that stage wasn't noticeable really at all on my head, I think that was the start of the process. So I don't want to worry you, because it is very normal for your hair to fall out if you are, it just, you know, just normal, even if you're not going bold. But if there's a significant amount and you're noticing it potentially on your pillow, in the shower, as you run your hands through your hair, all three of those, then that could potentially be a sign that's the beginnings of losing your hair. And the third sign to help you identify whether you're going bald is photo evidence. So maybe look back at a few photos from a year or two ago, potentially longer, to see what your hairline or the thickness of your head on top or your crown used to be like. This is by far the easiest way to identify because, you know, as you look at your hair every day in the mirror, you may not notice the gradual changes that are happening. Whereas if you have a look at a photo from a year or two ago, then you can notice if there's been a shift in your hairline at the crown. So I think just I don't want to say keep checking photos because that's really not good mentally. That's very mentally draining. But if you're just trying to identify whether you are starting to go bald, then potentially just have a look at one or two photos from a year or two ago and compare. So that's by far the easiest way, guys. If your hairline looks exactly the same, chances are you're okay. You're not going bald yet. But if there is some movement, there could be, you know, that could be the start of starting to go bald. So yeah, check the photos as that's by far the easiest way. So you've checked all those three steps and you've decided, shit, I'm starting to go bald. The panic's setting in, you know, you're starting to worry, stress levels are rising. I'm here to tell you, going through that journey myself, I promise you, it's not as bad as you initially think. And it's not really a problem at all, even though initially it can seem like it. There's a lot of stigma around losing your hair. Everything, you know, that you see on TV, on adverts, is aimed at sort of, you know, getting your confidence back by getting your hair back, loads of treatments. You may have heard of going to Turkey if you're in the UK to get hair transplants, starting minoxidil and finasteride, which is medication to help slow the loss of your hair. I always advocate, guys, for if it's happening, by far the best solution I've found is to shave your hair, even if it's a buzz cut or a razor shave, as by doing that, it helps liberate you of your hair loss worries. So yes, I know it can be a big thing to start off with, but I promise you there's light at the end of the tunnel. I always encourage guys to make peace with it, to accept their balding rather than fight it, because fighting it takes up so much mental energy, it drains you, and that's not what I want for any of you guys. I always encourage to focus on what you can control. As I said, hair loss is 90% genetic. Some guys have a full head of hair right until they're in their old age and then lose it rapidly. Some guys start to gradually lose their hair in their maybe late teens or 20s. Either way, you can't control it. So that's it for me, guys. I hope that helps. As I said, if you've done those three steps and it looks like you are starting to go bald, don't worry. I've got lots of content on my channel which can help you out, which could potentially answer some of your questions. So I hope that helps. Take care and I'll see you next time.